Let's look at the solution to our memory refresh quiz. We have a memory with 4096 rows and this many columns. It needs to be refreshed every 500 microseconds, and this is our read timing, where these two steps and this one overlap. So basically, it takes us 4 plus 10 plus either 11 or 2 plus 4 nanoseconds before we complete one read and can proceed with the next one. Because 2 plus 4 is 6 and 11 nanoseconds is longer, that means that really the timing for a read will be to select the row. So we need to select a row, get the values from the row, and then write the data back. During this time, the row needs to remain selected, so the new read really cannot begin until 4 plus 10 plus 11 nanoseconds into it. So the read takes 25 nanoseconds, and that means we could be doing 40 million reads per second if all we had to do is do reads. And this is where it becomes tricky, because during a second, we need to do a number of refreshes. The refresh period is 500 microseconds, so the number of refreshes we have to do is 2,000 times per second. We need to do a refresh of each of the rows. To do that, the row needs to be selected. We need to get the bit value and write it back, so it takes the same time to do a refresh of the row as it takes to do a read. Meanwhile, our memory cannot be doing the read. So really, we are spending 2,000 times 4,096 times 25 nanoseconds on refreshes, but because they have the same timing as reads, we can just compute how many refreshes we have per second. And we end up with 8.192 million refreshes per second, and that means that we cannot do all 40 million reads. Pretty much out of these, really, this was assuming that we don't do refreshes, so because we have to do 8 and change million refreshes, we have that many less reads that we can do. So the overall result here is the difference between the two. That's how many reads do we have left after we have spent time on 8 and change million refreshes. So the final answer here is the difference between these, which is 31,808,000 reads per second. So again, without refreshes, we would be able to do 40 million, but because refreshes need to happen, we only have this many reads left in a second.